And what that translates to with the client is not pushing this way, but actually pushing straight down. Okay. So the first step for this, I'm going to want to walk up and down. So also just make sure I take a foot out while it keeps the shape. Bring this over here. And trace up the back. That's step one. Definitely want to be able to do that. This is just doing a really good job of keeping her legs, keeping fully engaged, fully locked out. Alright, so the next step is you walk up. And our first thing we're going to do is walk, we're going to look with gravity and pop it down. So a little pop and look for the hips catching. This is also a good way to practice the catch of front plate twist pop to straddle back, right? So you're catching the straddle back.
Okay, straddle back. I don't want to scare anyone, but we know that people have popped their heads coming down. That's really not good for spines. So we're going to ask that you curl your chin.
Right.
It should be easier because we're going from a high position to a low position.
Once you walk down, you'll walk back up.
So I'm trying to keep my body in a flat plane. I'm using my arms, and as I'm twisting, I'm pushing straight down. And I'm pushing straight down, that's my shoulders. Right? So at first, I'm kind of pushing straight down, and I'm pulling it to the side, and then directly under my shoulders.
Which is always pushing.
I'm always pushing down. Where down is, changes.
Yeah. As a base, I am also pushing, but I'm always trying to get the ground as high up for my flyer as possible, so we have something to push against. Start with a negative, which is start down. So I want to do a really clean pop up. I'm pushing through the arms, looking for the hips to catch. And then it's the receive of my hand in front of my back.
Because I'm not worried about the hands getting in the way, so I can really fall down.
Yeah, that was one of the things. No, we're in poppers.